how do you think, I mean, how do you think you've dealt with the up and downness? Where you don't know, you can play this week or not, you have a season or not. How do you deal with that as a young athlete? Like, what goes through your head? You just try not to pay attention to it. You always have a backup. Yeah. You say, you know what, if I don't play, I'm still going to go out and get my work in. I'm still going to go get my training. I'm going to go get my hitting. I'm going to get my whatever, my fielding. You always have a backup. That's good. I like that. I like that mindset. That's good. That's positive. See, what you're doing is you're flipping it, right? So you're taking a negative situation and you're making it into a positive situation. And that's what allows growth. So a lot of people, what they do, they take negative, they turn to a negative, they complain. Oh, we can't play, oh, this and all, and point fingers and blame people. At some point, right, just gotta go, you know what? I gotta control what I can control, right? And I gotta just respond to it with something that's gonna help me elevate. Because if I don't respond with something that's gonna help me elevate, then I'm just gonna be stuck where I'm at. And it's gonna get worse. I'm gonna get more sad, more depressed, and I'm not gonna get better at whatever I'm trying to get better at, right? So that mindset is so important, right? Like you said, right? Say, I'm still gonna get more work in. I'm still gonna stay dedicated, I'm gonna stay hopeful, and when that time does come, where everything goes back to normal, right, you're gonna be ready. You're gonna be that much far ahead because you focused in that moment, right, where everybody else was blah, 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 you were working. See that? And that's what separates the great from the mediocre. That's great, I like that. Why do you think leadership is so hard? One moment you slip up, what they gonna do? They on you, right? They on your head. It's so tough because you're not only leading, you're carrying a full load of accountability. So as soon as you do something wrong, they're gonna go at you. Even when your follower or your teammate does something wrong, they're gonna come at you. See that? But that's the good thing at the battle. The good thing is we can take it. We can make sure that we have the plan right in place to respond. Right, things go wrong. So even though they point the finger at you when the things go bad, we're able to say, hey, okay, that's us, that's me, I did it. I take responsibility for whatever happened, you know, with our team, for my followers, for the people that I'm leading. I take responsibility. But when we come back with this response to it, this positive response, I want you guys to make sure you give us the admiration, the same amount of admiration as you gave, you know, when you gave us that critique. We want the same amount of admiration when we respond. You know what I'm saying? So leadership is a great thing. You know, it's what we need in the world right now. You know, all different levels in our families, in sports, in politics, you know, in religion. You know, so it's a great thing to hear the youth. It's inspiring for me to hear the youth talk about wanting to be better, wanting to change things, right? And being vocal and not being afraid to stand up when nobody else is standing. It's such a hard thing to do. We had the protests over at, gathering over there at River Park. And you know, you heard what those speakers were saying. And I mean, the themes are really simple. It's just be kind to people. I mean, everybody said whatever they said, but at the end of the day, all I heard was be kind. And if you just follow that simple premise in everything you do in your life, right, everybody's gonna be fine, right? He's good, whatever, you got disagreement, whatever. Be kind, just be kind, even in a disagreement. I'm not gonna hate you just because we're not connecting on whatever topic. There's so many different issues in the world going on that people have different views upon. But if I just be kind to you, we're gonna be able to kind of find some middle ground. That kindness is always that glue, you see that? It's always gonna bring people together, but when you don't have that kindness and you got that hate, it's always gonna be a blocker. It's always gonna be a blocker for us to connect with people. So that's one thing that that I'm really trying to bring into the world just in my personal life, is just to be kind. So even if somebody says something negative to me, I'm always kind back. I'm not gonna respond with more vileness, more evil, more hate. I'm gonna control it, right? You see that? You're in control. Everything that comes at you, you can either respond to it with a negative, like we talked about earlier, or you can control it and say, I'm just gonna respond with a positive, right? And if somebody's really, really, really nasty, you don't say nothing at all. You just let it ride. Let it go. Because there's no point in that one. You're not gonna be able to change that. You're just gonna let, you're gonna have to let that, take that to the team, right? But everything else, I'm gonna just be kind. God bless you. Oh, thank you for your words. So be it. And you move forward. That shows maturity, and that shows that you're ready to grow and you're ready to change the world. Because if we're always angry, we can't really help anybody. If we always got hate in our heart, we can't help nobody. If we got unforgiveness in our heart, we can't help nobody. So we gotta make sure that we're right first, and then we can change the world. See what I'm saying? We all can start one person at a time. One person doing it, guess what? You got 1,000, and 10,000 people, and 1,000,000 people are doing it. And now you got everybody else just working towards that same goal, which is love. Okay? So keep doing what you're doing. I'm proud of you, okay? Love you. Getting practice to the fits.